ways, mental health has been the whole in holistic mission. It's been a key piece that has not, because it's so complex and there are many different ways of looking at mental health problems from a spiritual dimension, to think of it in terms of cultural differences. And so it's been hard for the global church to get its head and heart around how to help people who may be struggling to different degrees with depression, anxiety, or other kind of problems or family problems. And there are many different perspectives. And also it's something that can be frightening for people to think about how, what it means to have some kind of problem with one's thinking and one's feeling. And so there's been a lot of fear, which has translated into an attitude of stigmatizing people and being concerned about engaging with them, not knowing what to do.
People, especially inside of the church, still have a very hard time talking about these kinds of things and sort of integrating their whole being and understanding that there is a spiritual aspect to it sometimes, but that mainly there are a lot of mental disorders and many things that have to do with the environment where they work at. And so I feel like people are not safe to talk about these things, so we should bring these things into conversation.
People with mental health issues can be rich, poor, people of color, white people. Everyone can be affected. There's no rhyme or reason to it.
Christians who had mental disorders, this was in the late 70s, Christians with mental disorders were not treated well in their churches. Their Christian fellowships didn't help them, and often they harmed them. Instead of encouraging, they would shame. So there was an experience as a young man when I wanted to become a missionary that the world needs Christians who could deal with emotional disorders in a way that is helpful and not harmful.
In the past, the church hasn't been great at responding to individuals with mental health. I think a lot of people have felt quite stigmatized or sort of neglected or ignored, because I think a lot of it is to do with maybe ignorance around what mental health is and how to respond to that. Or there's been an understanding that it's entirely spiritual. So, you know, if you just pray enough or have enough faith or, just believe that God can heal you from this, then it'll all be okay, which is kind of, I guess, a misunderstanding about how mental health works and how it develops.
I feel like more and more people are struggling, and we are we're not doing a very good job in integrating our lives, physical, emotional, spiritual. And the church, when the church thinks that it's not their job to care for people as a whole, we start to lose people.
We can very easily think of mental health as an individual problem, but very often it's a social problem, it's a community or even societal issue. When societies are not built around strong communities, around strong families, I think that's when breakdowns happen and when people are more vulnerable to mental health problems.